This is Dr. Jeremy Jones from radiopedia.org, and today we're going to be looking at radial head dislocation and the importance of the radiocapitellar line. Here are three cases of children who have presented to the emergency department with elbow pain after a fall. Take a look at them and work out if there is a radial head dislocation. If you're not already viewing this in high definition, give it a try. Obviously, the elbow joint is made up of three bones: the humerus, the ulna, and the radius. They all articulate at the radial ulna and radial humeral joints. The radial head sits in the radial notch of the ulna and is held in place by the annular ligaments that surround the joint capsule as it extends over the articulation with the capitellum. The capitellum is the first elbow ossification center to develop and an extremely helpful landmark at the elbow. The anterior humeral line runs along the anterior surface of the humerus and must intersect the middle third of capitellum. We'll cover this more in our next video. The other line, and the one that is key to diagnosing radial head dislocation, is the radiocapitellar line. On all views, if you draw a line along the radial neck, it should intersect the capitellum. If you dislocate your radial head, the line drawn down the neck of the radius doesn't intersect the capitellum. However, it's important to draw the line accurately. If you draw it along the radial shaft, the line may still intersect the capitellum if the dislocation is subtle. So be aware of the normal angulation of the radial neck and draw the line correctly. Let's look at a case. The capitellum, radial head, internal epicondyle, and the trochlea are ossifying. There is an elevated posterior fat pad indicative of an elbow effusion and a fracture through the lateral condyle. On the lateral view, we can draw in our capitellum, followed by the radial head and neck, and the radiocapitellar line. The line intersects the capitellum, and there is therefore no dislocation, despite lateral condylar fracture. On the AP, we can draw in the capitellum, radial head, and neck, and then the radiocapitellar line. Independent of projection, the radiocapitellar line should intersect the capitellum. Let's look at our cases again. Here's case A. Let's highlight the capitellum and the radial head and neck. When we draw the radiocapitellar line, it doesn't intersect the capitellum. This radial head is dislocated. Moving on to case B, we can highlight the capitellum again. With the radial head and neck outlined, we can draw the radiocapitellar line. Again, we see that it doesn't intersect with the capitellum. The radial head is dislocated. And on to case C. This is a slightly older child. Note the ossifying olecranon. Let's highlight the capitellum, radial head, and neck, and draw in the radiocapitellar line. This time the line intersects the capitellum, so there is no dislocation. This doesn't mean the film is normal though. Note this markedly elevated fat pad. This highlights the elbow effusion caused by hemarthrosis, secondary to a condylar fracture, highlighted here. So we've looked at all three cases and seen two of them have radial head dislocation. We've learnt that the radiocapitellar line is key to assessment of elbow alignment and that it should intersect the capitellum, should do so in any projection, and that it should be drawn along the neck of the radius, not the shaft. Check out our other pediatric elbow tutorials, as well as the rest of our videos at Radiology Channel on YouTube.